former champions are matched today, North Carolina and North Carolina State.
NBC Sports, proud to be college basketball's first network. Today, it's the North Carolina Tar Heels versus the Wolfpack of NC State. Brought to you by Budweiser. Beechwood Age for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. By the U.S. Army, a place to be all you can be. By the American Express card, don't leave home without it. And by Plymouth, division of Chrysler Corporation. Plymouth, the pride is back. Born in America again.
This is Dick Enberg with Al McGuire, ready for the rivalry in Raleigh, Carolina against State. The battle in the Atlantic Coast Conference, the nation's toughest, continues this afternoon on the campus of North Carolina State. The current ACC standings find the Blue Devils of Duke a half game in front of North Carolina, upset at home this week by Maryland. Georgia Tech in the top five in the nation, Virginia, North Carolina State 6-6, but a team that has already beaten Kentucky, Louisville, and UNLV. They're looking for a tournament spot again. Hello, everyone. I'm Dick Enberg. Before we get to the setup of today's heated rivalry, State and North Carolina, injury news that involved Steve Hale, the outstanding senior guard for the University of North Carolina. This is last year, the NCAA tournaments against Middle Tennessee State. He separates his shoulder in that collision, lost for the tournament. Carolina did not make it to the Final Four. Now, this is last Thursday night against Maryland. He runs into Len Bias, the knee of Bias into the chest of Hale. He suffered a partially collapsed lung, was hospitalized, out of the hospital this morning, has returned to the bench, but will not play. Hello, now we introduce Al McGuire. The injuries to key players, many teams could not afford to lose the likes of a Steve Hale.
Well, Carolina has a long bench, but Dick, it's very important at this time of the year that you have your team playing on an uptick and injuries stay away. Carolina cannot afford more injuries.
But they have another injury, and that's not good news for Dean Smith. Along with Hale on the bench today, out of uniform, is seven-footer Warren Martin. He has a bad foot, injured on Thursday night as well, re-injured, did not suit up today, so they lose two of their top six players.
Well, Warren Martin is their leader blocker of shots, but the key thing they lose with Warren Martin is five personal fouls on the baseline.
So North Carolina State not only has the home court advantage, they're tough here at Reynolds, but they play Carolina minus two of the top players for the Tar Heels.
I would say that North Carolina State is favored in today's game. And for Carolina to get out here with a win, even though they are number one, they'd be very fortunate.
So we're set to go in Raleigh, North Carolina. And North Carolina State, renewing that rivalry, will have the introduction of the starting lineups in just a moment. With the injury suffered, a remade lineup for North Carolina State. Joe Wolf will start. Curtis Hunter in the starting lineup. Dave Popson not starting. Dean Smith wants to keep a big man on the bench. Brad Doherty, leading scorer for the Tar Heels. Jeff Lebo, the freshman, and Kenny Smith for the 25-2 Carolina Tar Heels of Dean Smith, now in his 25th year. For North Carolina State, in white, it'll be Shackelford, the freshman, Bolton, the left-hander, Washburn, the talented sophomore, Nate McMillan, and senior Ernie Myers. 17-9, the Wolfpack of Jim Valvano. We're underway, and North Carolina State controls. Nate McMillan, the 6'5 backcourter. Washburn comes out of the post, Doherty on him. Inside to Shackelford. Bolton likes to shoot from outside, drives on Hunter. North Carolina State takes the early lead.
You got to remember now in the baseline, North Carolina only has a three-man rotation rather than a fourth with Martin sitting out.
Jeff Wolf off to Kenny Smith. Inside to Doherty to tie it up. Good ball movement by Carolina. They played earlier in Chapel Hill. That game won by North Carolina by 11, but it was a four-point game with 5 minutes to go.
Problem with North Carolina State at the guard position, they have no authentic or original or good point guard.
Myers, the senior, makes it 4-2, Wolfpack. Joe Wolf, not there. Doherty gets the garbage. Wolf comes in and was fouled by Bolton. First foul of the game against Benny Bolton of State. He's from Washington, D.C. Went to DeMatha High School. Played on three consecutive city championships. Part of that DeMatha to Raleigh line. Wittenberg, Carr, Hawkeye Whitney, Sidney Lowe, Quentin Jackson, others from DeMatha that migrated here to play at North Carolina State.
Well, the Washington connection, the best thing about him is his outside shooting.
Doherty way outside himself. Kenny Smith, lightning quick. Wolf with a turnaround, not there. Bolton rebounds.
Carolina's playing a real aggressive man-to-man, trying to turn over the guards of North Carolina State.
Lebo Hawking Myers. Shackelford, turnaround jumper. Comes back out to Myers. Washburn. Fine drive, 6-2. Two minutes gone. Doherty. Jump hook. Rebound Shackelford. Wolfpack leading 6-2. Myers. Shackelford. 8-2 for the Pack. Ernie Myers, there's an unusual foul. Myers taking the fake, went by, and on the way actually kicked Lebo accidentally for his first.
What happens down this end, if you notice, Hunter does not box out. Watch Hunter. He doesn't box out. Shaq comes in, automatic deuce.
Carolina with only 2 points in the first 2.5 minutes.
Got to start shooting from the outside a little bit.
Inside, bad pass, but a pushing foul on Bolton, and that will be his second.
It's a good call. Bolton had his hands on the hips of Wolf.
Dean Smith agrees. Jim Valvano, his counterpart on the state bench, barking a bit at that whistle. Valvano, now the athletic director at North Carolina State next year. Doherty, he's fouled by Myers, so Myers and Bolton, the starting forwards for North Carolina State, have two fouls each.
That's going to create a problem for the Wolfpack. Four already. They're only two away or three away from the one-on-one situation. And Carolina's an outstanding foul shooting team.
Brad Doherty at the line, the seven-footer from Black Mountain, North Carolina, averaging 20 points a game. He is the nation's third best field goal shooter, 65%, just under 70% from the line. He's had an All-America year. 8-4.
He would have to be considered as one of the candidates for player of the year. Here's the little touchdown pass. The pass was thrown wrong. When you're going to throw that pass, gang, always alley-oop it towards the basket. Let the man that's breaking down, Chris Washburn, who has moves of a 6'2" guard. You throw the alley-oop pass down court towards the opponent's basket or towards your basket.
North Carolina State likes that play. Joe Wolf misses again. He's cold. Gets his own rebound. Puts it back out to Lebo. Rebound. Shackelford rips it down.
I don't know if Wolf is cold or Chris Washburn is forcing him to re-cock his shot. Here goes Chris up down.
Washburn. Rebound Doherty. Kenny Smith on the run. Blocked from behind. Myers. 10-4 for North Carolina State.
That's what Nick McMillan brings to the table. He's a point guard at around 6'6", 6'7". That was all leather, that block.
Curtis Hunter not there. Wolf rebounds. Inside to Doherty. Blocked by Shackelford. Traveling on Myers. Came to a skidding stop.
Give credit to Wolf that time for working down court. Watch this block on Doherty.
Watch how quick he gets up.
Charles Shackelford, he's just a freshman from Kinston, North Carolina. Dave Popson, 35 in for North Carolina. He has the ball now.
Popson's a street fighter type player.
He's 6'9".
Has no fear.
He misses his first jumper and a foul on Curtis Hunter.
If Popson has a problem with his shooting, the trajectory of his shot is too low.
We have a timeout here in Raleigh. 15:49 remaining first half. State by 6. So stay tuned. Some of the best of the NFL involved in activities away from football. Always fun to see who really are the outstanding athletes. North Carolina coming into the game. The Tar Heels lead the nation from the floor, shooting 57.5%. Kansas, the Jayhawks with a great year. Michigan State second and third. They're about to set a new record, are the Tar Heels, but they start out ice cold, 1-for-11 against State today.
They're in the single digits. That's about 8.5%.
It's uncommon for Dean Smith's club, but also means that in just a 6-point game, North Carolina State, you know that Carolina's going to start hitting.
Well, they don't have the cohesiveness. When you take two starters out of a team, that's difficult. It takes a little time to get confidence back in your game.
Backcourt pressure by Kenny Smith on McMillan. State does not have a pure guard. McMillan really is a wingman playing the point.
Well, what he brings again to the table, he sees over zones and over the opponent. He's hard to trap.
Good defense, but a save by Washburn to help out. Inside to Washburn. Rebound Bolton. And the ball wedges, and the arrow points toward Carolina.
That only supposed to happen in playground.
Number 20, Steve Bucknell. 6'5 freshman from London, England, comes in for North Carolina. Hunter is out.
Bucknell's only playing basketball for 4 years. He came to the United States to play basketball. He started out at Cowan's basketball camp. That's Dave Cowan, the fellow that played for Boston Celtics. College at Florida State.
Bucknell inside to Doherty, tipped by Popson, pushing off on Popson. His first. Five minutes have been played. Popson out. Wolf back in.
A little bit more pressure up court, looking to double team the big guards from North Carolina State. Smith should go over and get him. He doesn't.
Wolf goes down holding his thigh. Rebound Doherty. Wolf limping down court. Bucknell hits Wolf, surprises him with a pass, but Wolf saves.
Right now, the refs could call a referee's timeout because of Wolf's injury.
He is really favoring that leg. It's Wolf with the ball, but he's not 100%. Doherty with a quick move, and someone got him on the wrist. Let's go back to the other end. Watch Joe Wolf. Number 24, he'll be down in the corner. There he is. He goes down, holding his left knee, left thigh.
They'll take him right out with Popson. Take a look at that thigh.
Well, he's staying in for the moment.
No, I'm kind of surprised at that. Because right now that thing's starting to cool off.
And last foul on Bolton was his third. So early in the game, Bolton has to rest with three quick ones. Chucky Brown, 52, from Leland, North Carolina, replaces him. He's a 6'7 freshman.
Big statistic, 5 personal fouls on the Wolfpack, 2 on the Tar Heels.
Doherty gets 1 out of 2. Here comes Popson back in. And it's Doherty that goes out.
Wolf must have gave him a sign that he's okay. Here's that pressure up court that had to come sooner or later.
10-5, North Carolina State leads. From Greece.
Wolf answers for North Carolina. It's 12-7 with 6 minutes gone. McMillan. Nate McMillan has four. Fast pace start of this game.
State still playing a man-to-man. Jeff Lebo has to start putting them up.
Lebo, good move inside, sets up Wolf over Fasulis. Not there. McMillan, 3-on-2. He'll slow it up.
Very steady player, McMillan.
Washburn. Boy, he's starting to really feel his greatness, Washburn. He's a force.
Washburn is awful. Awesome, all the way.
9-point lead. Lebo, blocked by Fasulis. Recovered by Popson. Blocked by Fasulis again and tipped in by Popson. He just flipped it in with his left hand.
Stayed with it. I believe Fasulis leads the state in block shots.
He does with 53, and he has three already since coming in. Fouled on Wolf away from the ball.
If I had to pick a ball play in this particular game that's going to shine, I would say Madden.
Kevin Madden, the freshman from Staunton, Virginia, number
just got
22.
In. I'd say he's going to shine this game, Dick. He has great ability.
Ranzino Smith is also just in for Carolina, number 33.
Moved in a quicker team, again, to try to create turnovers. They're in a 2-3 zone right now, or 1-3-1.
Doherty, Wolf, the two big men with three guards, the two Smiths, and Madden. Ernie Myers not there. And unable to control the ball was Chucky Brown. There just was no one to get it to, and he was being bumped out of bounds.
Should have played it off the opponent's leg or arm or body that time.
Carolina trailing by 7 at 16-9. 12 minutes left, first half. Doherty, that's his shot. He can't hit. Doherty gets it back. Fasulis blocked again. Smith, Kenny Smith, makes it 16-11, his first bucket. 12 minutes left, first half. By Kenny Smith. You saw him almost commit a foul. He recovered, raced back, got his man, and deflected the pass.
That comes with maturity, also unbelievable athletic ability.
11 minutes, 37 seconds left in the half. Here's what's taken away from the Carolina attack by the injuries to Hale and Martin. Nearly 19 points between them. Hale's 5 assists and Martin's 5 rebounds, plus the fact with 79 blocked shots, he leads the conference, but it's more than that.
Well, what happens, Dick, Steve Hale is truly their leader. He's the son of a coach. He makes the big play at the end of the game, and he's just a scrambler, a hard-nosed player. When you go on to the Martin kid, what they're really losing is that four-man rotation inside the paint, plus the 5 fouls that he can give out there. You'll notice by the end of this game that Carolina's baseline will be in foul trouble.
North Carolina State leading by 5. 11 and a half minutes remaining. Doherty has the defense force the turnover. Kenny Smith off to Jeff Lebo. Lebo had himself airborne, and Carolina lucky to come up with the ball. Inside to Doherty. Misses the easy one. And Kevin Madden with a cup dunk.
No, I said he's going to have a big game. At North Carolina are all good. They're good and better. Kevin Madden has not got a chance to play this year. That guy can play ball.
Foul on Lebo. The basket is good.
Watch Horse here come in. This guy can play in Star Wars.
Meanwhile, at the other end, Ernie Myers with a chance at a 3-point play. His first trip to the line. He has 6 points in the game. It's a young state team. They're going to get nothing but better for Jim Valvano. He is really the only man they'll lose, along with McMillan. the two seniors.
Well, he's the only guy left from the championship team. The Miracle in Albuquerque.
19-13 on the three-point play by Ernie Myers. Doherty inside, blocked from behind by Shackelford. Boy, he's made some big defensive plays. Charles Shackelford, the 6'10 freshman.
I thought he got a piece from that time. Man to man, he's going uptown again. Here he goes.
Shackelford not there. Doherty with a rebound. He leads Carolina in rebounds as well as scoring. He's averaging 8.5 a game. Inside, Wolf, he misses again.
That big baseline from State has Wolf a little psyched out. But Wolf has had a great year. He really was the man that made them win against Georgia Tech, Duke, and Notre Dame.
Yeah, he's a 55% shooter. Myers, not afraid to gun. Wolf rebounds, and he was fouled. Reaching in, no basket, was Shackelford. His first. Madden goes out for North Carolina. Bucknell, Lebo, and Smith with the two big men, Wolf and Doherty.
Next foul by State's 1-1, and that will become the equalizer in the first half.
One of the freshmen playing guard and makes the bad pass.
Good steal there. If Nate McMillan is not playing, State has serious problems. He's not a true point guard. He's more an off guard or a small forward, but an outstanding athlete.
At the other end, Washburn was fouled by Doherty. Big Chris at the line looking for his fifth point.
Remember, Dick, I did a halftime show with him down at Laurinburg Prep. And he put an exhibition on of dunking and slamming that really brought goosebumps. And a lot of people say that his body at 6'11 is the finest body of any athlete.
He carries 254 pounds, runs the floor, very agile. State has its biggest lead, 10 points.
Nice move to a tight zone with a 10. Shaq did, and out of bounds. Watch the action. It's a trap, a very bad pass. You know what?
Pops and out of bounds.
As long as Shaq is out of bounds, and it should have been, State's out. Alley-oop.
Doherty scores on the assist from Kenny Smith. Doherty has 7.
Coach B is very upset on that play happening.
8:45 left in the opening half.
No time in bringing the ball up. Excellent pass inside then by Matt.
Shackelford walks. Or Washburn, rather. Dean Smith, one of three to win the NIT, the NCAA championship, and coach the Olympians to a gold medal. Pete Newell and Bobby Knight, the others. Foul. Late whistle on Shackelford. That'll send Brad Doherty to the line.
Shackleford was out of position defensively. You can't play Doherty from behind like that. It's impossible. Caught him with the body.
Brad Doherty, the senior for North Carolina, is granddaddy, a full-blooded Cherokee Indian. He's very young. He's only 20 as a senior. We've watched him grow in so many ways in his 4 years at Chapel Hill, and now a legitimate star.
He will go in the lottery in the NBA. He'll be one of the top seven ball players picked.
North Carolina whittles State's lead to 6 with just under 8 minutes left in the half. Oh my, back in ACC country a week from today. And if there is any argument about number one, it'll be resolved over at Cameron Indoor Stadium. They're only 8 miles apart, the two campuses. The Tar Heels and the Blue Devils next Sunday, and then 2 weeks from today, will be in Greensboro for the ACC Championship and the announcement for the John Wooden Award, college basketball's top player at halftime. And the coach will be with us, Coach Wooden.
Well, a lot of people are going to say Duke's number one, North Carolina's number one. If North Carolina wins today, I think they'll still hold the number one position. But Virginia's coming into North Carolina later in this week, and Virginia knocked North Carolina off earlier in the season.
Carolina's two losses to Virginia, and this last week to Maryland. Lenny Bias had a sensational game to lead the Terrapins. Benny Bolton with the ball. He has 3 fouls back in the game.
He knows McMillan sees over Smith. That's what's good about having a point guard that size.
Inside to Washburn. Blocked by Doherty. Trailing by 6. Carolina once down by 10. Inside to Doherty. Jump hook. Popson. Especially human people.
Human, 1,000 arms.
But here it is from behind them.
Watch the arms keep going up there. The big brother camera.
Like tentacles.
Get those arms up there again. Here we go. Volleyball at its best.
But it was Dave Popson who kept it alive, scrapping. He must have touched it 5 times. Then Doherty finally slammed it home. It's a 4-point State lead with under 7 minutes left before the half. Benny Bolton with a leaping Lena. Bolton's first points. Joe Wolf. Boy, Wolf has had a terrible first half.
Teddy Nate McMillan. Doesn't get too much puff. Steady every game. Doesn't panic. Charge yet. Normally gets 1 or 2 charges a game.
Bolton back out to Washburn, stolen by Lebo, and the arrow points toward State.
They'll stay down that end of the court.
You think Valvano's already in the tournament? Do you really think he needs to win one of these last 2 or 3?
No. The ACC will go 5, possibly 6. Outside shot 7, whoever wins the postseason conference tournament.
Branzino Smith comes in for Jeff Lebo. In other words, you're figuring on the front runners, North Carolina, Duke, and Georgia Tech.
Virginia State.
North Carolina State. Maybe Maryland.
Lefty needs one more upset.
Away from the ball, Joe Wolf holding his second. Right, and that sends North Carolina State into the bonus. Halftime. different side of my colleague Al McGuire. Very special day in his hometown of Milwaukee, and it has nothing to do with basketball. So stay with us at the intermission. We'll have Coach Al on the run.
You know, Dick, we're looking out here at North Carolina State that possibly we get to the Final Four. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There's unbelievable talent. And come in from the West.
Air ball out of bounds on the side to Carolina. 28-21 the score.
They got so much height. They got so much height down low. And if their guards can hold up, the only thing again that they're missing is that true point guard. Nate McMillan does a great job at it, but I think they'd have problems trying to delay a game. So handling the lead, they should have problems.
28-21, North Carolina State. 5.5 minutes remain before the intermission. Patsoulas turned his head, so Doherty took the baseline, and the foul is on Doherty.
If I have to put a little bit of rap on Tar Heels in this game, they're looking inside too much. This was an obvious charge. Nice pick on the weak side there. There's a second pick coming over on Patsoulas. A switch occurred, and Doherty charged.
And Patsoulas was injured on the play. Let's see if we can follow Patsoulas. He's screened out behind Doherty. You see, he runs into Bolton and lands on that right knee, and he is limping off.
I think what happened just before he went down, I think their knees met. I think it was Popson that banged his knee just before he went down, Dick, if we could see that one more time.
He hits the floor pretty hard as well, Coach. Watch Patsoulas, number 13, in the back of the action.
Now, right. Oh, I had to go back a little bit further. You're probably right, Dick.
Nevertheless, Patsoulas is out, and number 40, Taven Benz, a 6'10 junior from the Bronx, New York, will come in.
They need Patsoulas in this game. He clogs up the middle, doesn't have great foot speed, an unbelievable rejector. Trap zone.
State with the ball and a 7-point lead.
Big asset having big guards. They see right over Lee Bowen Smith.
Inside to Benz. Stolen by Lebo.
Numbers are right. I give it to Hunter. Too late.
Kenny Smith from the side. Four for Smith. Patsoulas is okay, and he's going to return to the lineup. He's at the scorer's table. McMillan, short, gets his own rebound, sets up. Washburn, what an assist by McMillan.
NBA All-Star play.
McMillan, he gives you 5-6 assists a game, 5 rebounds a game, averaging 9.5 points a game. Myers. McMillan. Myers. Rebound Wolf. Washburn hits the deck. He's okay. Lebo inside. Knocked away by Benz.
Quick hands on Benz that time.
Valvano telling McMillan, hey, slow it down, take it easy. Time running out of the half, and State with a 7-point lead.
Both teams in a 1-1, and the arrow favors North Carolina. Carolina man-to-man.
Washburn over Doherty. Chris Washburn with 10 points. Points the advantage for North Carolina State.
Trying to make a shoot from the outside.
Ben's first shot isn't there, but Bolton rebounds.
Bolton's
the one that should be shooting. He's the best percentage shooter from the outside.
Myers, he's not afraid to let it go. Washburn blocked by Doherty. And a foul on Doherty. His third.
I thought Doherty got ball that time. Let's take a look at it. Couldn't be body because he reached over. He had to reach over Hunter there.
Here's where they call the foul on the rebound.
Good call. Call the foul on the way coming down, not up.
So Carolina loses its top scorer and top rebounder, Brad Doherty, for the remainder of the half. He'll sit it out with three. 2.5 minutes left. 10 points for Doherty. Make that 13 for Doherty. The man at the line has 10, Chris Washburn.
Last time against North Carolina earlier in the season, he had 21 points. They call him the enforcer.
He leads State with an average of 16.7 a game and just under 7 rebounds.
Nobody his size can do things that he does with his body.
Shows a good touch as well, and with it a timeout. They've led throughout the half, North Carolina State.
All the excitement of college basketball is here. Next Saturday at 1 Eastern, the Wolfpack of NC State takes on Oklahoma. Then at 3 Eastern, 12 Pacific, the LSU Tigers battle the Wildcats of Kentucky, or DePaul meets UCLA, plus West Coast regional action. College basketball, it's the stuff Saturdays are made of on NBC.
So it'll be Kentucky and LSU next Saturday, and then North Carolina Duke on Sunday. When are we going to hear your pick for the Final Four? When are you going to announce that?
I will say the Final Four on my special on Sunday afternoon for the Final Two.
Playing it safe again, eh, Coach? But you like North Carolina State to make it in the tournament. That was a surprising comment. You think they're good enough to make it to the Final Four?
I thought last year, if Chris Washburn wasn't put off the team, that they had an excellent chance of going to the Final Four last year. They have unbelievable athletes. Surprisingly, I don't know what happened, they did not recruit a point guard. With the Smith on North Carolina State, they'd be in the top five in the country all year long. You got to remember, Dick, that Chris Washburn hasn't played basketball in 2 years, and Shacklefoot sat out the first 7 games this year for academic reasons.
Carolina with the ball down by 9. Bucknell back in for the Blue. Way off the mark is Dave Hobson. This has to be the Tar Heels' worst shooting performance of the season for a half. Carolina shooting 10 for 36. So they're shooting in the high 20s.
Well, one of the reasons is the size of that baseline on State. They make you think.
And between Shackelford and Washburn, now Pasulis is back in.
4 o'clock is down to 8 seconds.
4 seconds, McMillan. Comes back out to North Carolina State. Walker Lambiot. Washburn clears to McMillan. 1.5 minutes left. Oh, what a play. That was Madden who made the steal. Kenny Smith is fouled, pushing on McMillan.
Boy, Kenny Smith pulled up with a tough shot. And Nate McMillan made one of his rare mistakes. Foul the guy that far out is a no-no.
Well, that was a terrific leaping intercept by Madden at the other end. Kenny Smith, just a junior. There you see Madden, the freshman. Wants to be a Wall Street stockbroker after he finishes his basketball life.
He's one of the best transition guards around.
Unselfish. Second leading scorer for the Heels with a 12-point average.
I still think in the first half here that North Carolina has tried to force the ball inside too much.
Smith makes both. It's 34-27. The scoreboard hasn't given North Carolina the other point, is it? Now they do.
Thank you.
ball into Chris. Nate should put it in right now. Lambiot clears out.
20 seconds on the shot clock. Final minute.
There it is.
Washburn. He was fouled by Popson with the body.
He had no shot that time. He knew the whistle was going to blow, so he put the ball up.
Second on Popson. And Washburn to the line, where he is a perfect 4 for 4 today.
Coach B is saying, hey, let's stop fooling around. Go down there and just kick the ball down the blocks into Chris.
Looking for his 13th point of this first half.
With all the tools, that surprisingly went to 3 different high schools, which is kind of stupid. And so he never got into rhythm. And this is his first season getting into a little bit of rhythm. Now next year, he should really be considered first-team All-American.
Lambiot out. Washburn, I'll show you what kind of athlete it is. He long jumped 23 feet in high school, ran the hurdles. He's a perfect 6 for 6, and it's a 9-point lead again for State. Their biggest of the half was 10.
Jimmy's going to go to a very tight zone here, just trying to get in. He hopes with a 9-point lead, but he'd be happy with a 7.
6 seconds difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Carolina must shoot with about 10-9 seconds to go.
We call the game clock the countdown clock and the shot clock the small clock.
Shot clock is now at 11, 10, 9, 8, 7. Madden can't hit it. Out of bounds. Last touch by North Carolina.
Plenty of time for decent shots. The ball, I roll it for a while. Roll it to Nate. Don't touch it, Nate. Don't touch it. Don't touch it. Too soon. I have a tougher shot now.
McMillan. Washburn. It counts. North Carolina State leaves the floor with its biggest lead of the game. State 38, Carolina 27. Official first half statistics, a shocking field goal percentage.
That's the problem of the game for North Carolina, 30.3. That is their worst percentage shooting for the whole season in the first half.
In any half, in fact, they shot 38% in the second half at Marquette. Here's a team that leads the nation, 57.5%. North Carolina State throughout the year has been tough defensively, and they've shown the Tar Heels that today. The rest of the numbers, nothing really jumps out at you. 5-1 in block shots. Brad Daugherty, as expected, the leading Tar Heel scorer with 13. Kenny Smith with 6, but no one else with more than 2. Remember now, Warren Martin, Steve Hale will not play. They're on the bench out of uniform. Chris Washburn, a powerful 16 in the first half.
6-6 from the foul line.
Ernie Myers with 7 and Nate McMillan with 6. 3 fouls for Bolton. The only player in trouble for State, and Brad Daugherty starts the second half with 3.
Surprisingly at North Carolina, with Wolf having 2 and Lebo having 2.
The Wolfpack, they lost to Kansas, but they have beaten some top-ranked teams, UNLV, Kentucky, and Louisville. They play Oklahoma next Saturday.
They are automatically, believe me, Dick, in the NCAA. Don't ask me anymore, please.
Okay, I will not
you
ask
promise?
You. They're 17-9, even if they lose the rest of them. 17 will be enough. I'm not asking you.
Don't ask me.
Kenny Smith starts it for North Carolina.
Important to get out of the gate and get the crowd out of the game. This time down, they got to come up with something.
Joe Wolf back out to Kenny Smith. Carolina guard team reluctant to shoot. Kevin Madden starts in the 3-guard offense.
One of their problems, Dick, the people that guard them are much taller than them, 3-4 inches tall.
Two freshmen, Lebo and Madden, with Smith, with Daugherty and Wolf on the front line. Short, rebound Myers.
Madden did took because the clock was going down.
For North Carolina State, it's Chris Washburn, Shackelford, Bolton on the front line, McMillan and Myers. Same team that started. Washburn has it taken away for a moment. Bolton scores. Benny Bolton. The foul is against North Carolina's Kevin Madden.
Bolton took a good shot that time. He moved in at both feet planted. Madden could not change direction. Give you a peek at it. Here it goes.
State with a 13-point lead, and for North Carolina, a team that had only lost one starting a week ago, they're going to really have to get something good together to avoid losing two straight this week.
They have the ability to do it. They have the athletes and the coach to come back in the game. There's a lot of time left. They got to hit from the outside. They must.
Jeff Lebo doesn't. Doherty inside to score. Brad Doherty has 15.
Excellent flip, flick. Pass from Madden that time. He's playing under control. He hasn't got his charge yet. Myers always gets one charge a game. Put in there, Myers. Drive points.
Washburn. The jumper. Wolf trying to end his personal run. Still 11-point lead for State, 2.5 minutes into the second half.
He can't keep Joe down both halves.
Washburn got away with a little walk that time and loses the ball.
All the way.
Look at Smith. From Raleigh, copying his brilliant block back to back.
Show me Mr. Neal, David Neal, show me these shots. Watch him go up here. Beautiful, all left.
That's ballet. Nate McMillan, two sensational defensive plays. Touched at last.
Bolton pointing the other way and he knocked it out of bounds himself.
3.5 minutes gone. Boy, two sensational plays by McMillan. And there's another one. Shackelford forces the turnover. Deflected the ball right through Doherty's hands. Well, you love defense. This has to be the kind of game you enjoy.
Well, this is truly a playground-type game under the basket. Everybody's skying. The refs aren't calling goaltending. So letting them go upstairs, elevated at each end.
McMillan. Rebound Shackelford. 44-31. Shackelford has five.
Wolf has to pop it from the outside.
McMillan makes another play out of bounds to North Carolina State.
Dean's going to have to use one of his timeouts soon. I know he likes to save his fourth timeout, but he has to use one.
At 6'5", Nate McMillan led the Wolfpack in blocks last year with 35. Here's the first one in that sequence. Look at that form midair. McMillan denying Kenny Smith and yet not committing a foul. And then he came right back. A minute later, it was Jeff Lebo that tasted the same defensive genius. Oh, my.
Body control.
There he is, Nate McMillan. Leading the Wolfpack to a 13-point lead over Carolina. 16 minutes left in the game.
He's playing at home truly because he's from Raleigh.
Inside this big Chris Washburn. Just automatic. 20 points for Washburn. A huge lead for State.
Carolina has is over 15 minutes left in the half, so they got time to come back into this ball game.
Benny Bolton. You think they love it here at Reynolds? Oh. Good hustle by Kenny Smith to save another turnover.
Jeff Lebo has to start pumping.
Joe Wolf hits the turnaround jumper.
Another thing they got to start doing, they got to start trapping and gambling more. They've been too conservative, North Carolina. They missed Steve Hale.
I think Hale might be able to return in time for the Duke game next Sunday. And the same for Martin. Martin might be better in time for Virginia in the middle of the week. But both out of uniform today, in case you're joining us late. Two of the top six Carolina players.
Can't
Bolton.
Can't let him shoot. An unbelievable outside shot. One has been falling off him. But don't fall off Bolton.
10 points now for Bolton. Lebo. To McMillan. They would love nothing more here at North Carolina State than to rout their neighbors from Chapel Hill.
Jimmy's trying to have them kill some clock. It's a good coaching move, but I don't know. It scares me against North Carolina. His team's as hot as a $2 pistol. Yeah, they turned it over trying to be cute.
Kenny Smith.
He made sure no block that time. I'll dunk it. Where's McMillan, he said to himself going in.
That was Ernie Myers, who was down court for North Carolina State. 15-point lead with 13 minutes left.
You're taking the rhythm out of the game, B. The right coaching move, but not on this particular game.
But isn't this what you did? You'd start
well,
melting the
I
clock?
Would. Oh, sure I would. I'm saying it's the right coaching move, but North Carolina, you got them going. You know, blow them out of there. They're too good. You give them life. They score now, and they're back in the ballgame, no matter what the score is.
Curtis Hunter nails the line drive, 50-37, his first points.
And now Coach B has to call a timeout to regroup his team. He's calling a timeout with a 13-point lead. A good call, but I'm afraid he started to work the clock too soon.
It is an automotive advance whose time has come. The Mercedes-Benz Supplemental Restraint System, SRS. In a severe frontal impact, a driver's side airbag and emergency tensioning retractors in both front seat belts supplement 3-point seat belt restraint. All in a fraction of a second. SRS, only from Mercedes-Benz. And now standard equipment on every Mercedes-Benz for 1986.
Set your course. There's a world out there just waiting in the sky and on the sea.
Baby,
it's pride in history.
Baby,
seeing all there is to see. It's knowing that you're helping to keep us strong and free.
It's not just a job, it's adventure.
All the excitement of college basketball is here when the Tar Heels of North Carolina battle Duke. College basketball, it's the stuff Sundays are made of on NBC.
Sundays in the Carolinas on NBC, and we hope you'll be with us next Sunday. It'll be as noisy at the Duke University campus at Cameron Indoor Stadium as North Carolina and Duke will battle for probably bragging rights to the ACC regular season and then on to the ACC championship game 2 weeks from today from Greensboro. Also the announcement of the College Basketball Player of the Year, the John Wooden Award.
Next week at Cameron Stadium, there'll be some ball game.
North Carolina hopes these two men will be in uniform, a different uniform.
Well, I'm pretty sure that Martin will be, and I don't know the story on Steve. But I was going to stay at Cameron Stadium. I want to bring the peanuts for the animals there next week. That's a zoo.
Don't encourage him.
I love you, Duke. I love you. I love you. Leave me alone. I love you.
12 and a half minutes left. North Carolina State once with a 17-point lead. Now leading by 13 at 50-37.
Go down low, Chris Washburn, and let them throw the ball into you. Stop trying to be fancy. 20 seconds left on the small clock. Trying to melt. Too soon.
10-9 seconds.
Here goes a Hail Mary shot someplace.
Nate McMillan. Not there. But it's going to go out of bounds to Carolina.
That's enough said. I'm not going to talk about any more about working the clock too soon.
Pretty soon you won't say anything. 11:45 left.
Joe, you got to shoot from there. He's laying off you. You're one of the best shots on the team. Let it go, Joe.
That's his shot. Superb game McMillan has had. Bernie Myers off the assist of McMillan. He has 9.
Excellent move from in the back door. Zeno.
Ranzino Smith has his first hoop.
He's named after Sam Ranzino that played during my time. At North Carolina State he played. I was at St. John's.
Ranzino is from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. 2 years ago he was the North Carolina High School Player of the Year. Washburn.
Destroy the rim.
Litigation. Washburn with 22.
Off their delay the last 2 minutes or so and got back into that early rhythm. Talking about State.
Second half. Bolton goes out. Chucky Brown is in. Washburn can't hit. Doherty rebounds.
Jeff should pull up on this one.
Look at Washburn hustle. Smith scores, but Washburn at 250 was with Smith step for step. They weren't in the same flight pattern, but he was getting back. 10 minutes left. Midpoint of the second half. Myers not there. Rebound Doherty. Carolina on the run. Penny Smith to Lebo. Nice play by Jeff Lebo. 54-43.
Watch him try to trap right now. That's Dean style. Where's the trap going to develop? Now, I thought they trapped, trying to get a run going. They're right back in there now, 11. They can drop to that single digit. It'll tighten up State a little bit. Slow down. Let Shaq and Wash go down low. Hammer away. Take advantage of Martin not being eligible to play. Able to play. Excuse me. He's eligible, obviously. Oh, what a pass.
Basket is good. Washburn with the assist to Chucky Brown.
Fantastic. Only an athlete can show that one. Oh,
Kevin Madden sends Chucky Brown to the line. He's a freshman from Brunswick High School in Leland, North Carolina, averaging 4 points a game. Over the top, Fasulis.
Fasulis thought he was pole vaulting that time. Put his arm on Wolf's shoulder and just pole vaulted up. Maybe they allow that. Where's he from? He's from Italy?
Greece.
Somewhere in the Mediterranean.
State leading with less than 9 minutes left. Inside Dorney with a left hand, the foul on Shackelford with a body. His third.
Shackelford is going to say here, he says, hey, all I did is put my arms up. I did not move. Watch Shaq. He'll just put his arms up. Get him up, Shaq. Now you're pushing him a little bit. Now he just keeps his arms up. Now keep him up. Don't put him down, Shaq. Keep him up for a little bit longer. That's nice. Keep him up there, son. That's good. In comes the enforcer.
Washburn in and Shackelford out. 6'10 Shackelford replaced by the 6'11 Washburn. Doherty nails a couple more and has 17 in the game. Back to an 11-point state lead.
What an athlete.
McMillan at 6'5. Washburn, the way he bounces around, he just plays so enthusiastically.
He bounces into rhythm. Watch him, he gets the ball. He'll have a little bounce after he gets it, then he'll put it up.
Stolen by Joe Wolf. Here's Carolina's chance to cut to 9.
Jeff is free.
Lebo. And it is a 9-point state lead. 56-47. Less than 8 minutes remaining. A 17-point lead into a 7-point lead on Curtis Hunter's steal.
And a pressure up court with a timeout by Jimmy Bean. That leaves him only with 2 timeouts left.
A 10-point change for Carolina from 17 to 7 points down. As you said, Coach, North Carolina and State with some great athletes. They can only play 5 at a time.
We have no bad players, good and better.
7 minutes, 39 seconds left. Welcome back to Reynolds Coliseum, where North Carolina State enthusiastically enjoying that big 17-point lead in this half, and suddenly it's a game at 7.
Well, you're playing against the number one team in the nation, Dick. You never can take it easy. The coaching move that Jimmy B made is the proper move. I'm saying in this particular game, going against the heavyweight champ of the world, you've got to be very careful if you start playing the clock and not the opponent.
So there is you're just saying your gut reaction to it was, hey, I'm not going to, normally you'd want to as a coach to slow it down, but you would say at this time up by 17, let's try to get up by 27.
When I was coaching, I would have done the same thing B does, but as an announcer in today's game and looking at it from a different view, I guess, I would have kept it going. Because now Carolina's path will come into effect and they'll turn you over.
There it is. The 10 seconds. The clock showing that 34 seconds on the shot clock, so that makes it a little easier to make that 10-second call, or makes it more accurate, a more accurate call.
Dick, anytime you call a timeout, Dean is going to change his defense on you and try to turn you over, which he did that time. Here is an important basket for both teams. State doesn't want them to make it, obviously. Carolina just about needs it. Almost 7 minutes left in the game.
7 minutes and 14 seconds left. North Carolina seemingly out of the game early in the second half. Curtis Hunter isn't there. Bernie Myers rebounds. North Carolina State by 7.
Very simple play now. They'll work the clock a little bit to get it down into Chris.
Washburn comes up high.
That's only temporary. He'll go back down low with Shackleton.
Myers loses it out of bounds. Joe Wolf, rested for a couple of minutes, returns for Carolina, as does Kevin Madden. Hunter and Popson go out. So now Dean Smith with the two injuries, Warren Martin and Steve Hale out. Now he has his five best shooters on the floor.
Jeff Lebo has started to hit. He has two passes in the second half. Wolf can bottom it out. They got good shooters out there.
Joe Wolf. Ernie Myers gets the rebound. 6:24 left.
That was a big miss by Carolina. It has to go inside this time. They got to play Bolton honest out there. You got to play him honest. Oh, boy,
Bolton. Bolton, 12 points, mostly from outside. Washburn with a block. Wolf scores on the second effort. Joe Wolf with eight. 58-51, North Carolina State, 5:45 left.
And remember, Dean Smith has three timeouts remaining, and the arrow is favoring the Wolfpack. Get the ball down low this time, and Chris.
And a half minutes left. Shot clock at 18. That Lebo's a pesky defender. Bolton again. Oh, is he hot? Benny Bolton with 14. Doherty. Myers rebounds.
Now they go to more serious delay. Now you're inside that 5 minutes. The ball five times to win.
Shackelford. Lebo. Oh, Lebo took a slap in the face. Kenny Smith. And a blocking foul against State. Dean Smith looking for the goaltend as well, but that's not the call.
The reason that he didn't get called for charge, if you watch Smith, he puts his body sideways right here, which saved the charge and created a blocking call.
Nate McMillan picks up the foul, his second.
And they wanted on Shackelford a call of goaltending that time, which was no call.
10 points for Kenny Smith, just under his average.
Surprisingly for Kenny, he missed a big foul shot against Maryland. He usually doesn't do that. He stepped up to that line and beat Marquette earlier in the season. You can almost say it's automatic, especially down in prime time like this.
That was with Carolina leading by two and just seconds left. 7-point lead again for State. 4:39 left.
Watch for the football pass here. Touchdown pass. Everyone up close. There goes Chris. Don't give it all. Back it out. I now start to work the clock seriously. Back it out.
Washburn, no basket. Foul on Wolf before the shot. Valvano not happy at all with that result. Third on Wolf. By the way, as you saw yesterday, those towels are for sale. Just contact Valvano. He'll sell you anything. Put your name. He'll make it a big one, a small foul, whatever you want.
Carolina can still give two fouls before the 1-1. State's only committed two fouls in the second half. So State's in the driver's seat.
4:12 left. Wide open. Chris Washburn has 24.
Carolina quick. Dean now is getting into his coaching style, which he uses the end of every game. Now watch this monster dunk, this tomahawk dunk. Anything but a rocking chair dunk this is. Go get him, pal.
Three 3 minutes and 54 seconds remain. How come Don Cricky always gets those Hawaii assignments? That should be fun. We're seeing some super teams in the Atlantic Coast Conference, and we'll see the best of the NFL, guys like Dan Hampton, Ron Brown of the Rams, Steve Largent of the Seahawks, Miami's Mark Clayton, many others competing in non-football events. Hey, you used to have a suit made out of that material. Stay with us right after our game here from Raleigh, North Carolina, where State leads North Carolina by 7, 62-55. 3 minutes and 54 seconds remain.
Two timeouts each. Coach B wants ball control and poise right now. Obviously, Dean wants a T.O. turnover.
Bolton. Hawks. And a foul by Ranzino Smith. That'll send Benny Bolton to the line. Bolton is one of their better free throw shooters. 75.9%.
Excuse me, they still got another foul to give.
Oh,
that's only
they won't. Okay.
And they'll give another one
right
away.
Two more, that's right. Do they want to force that situation? Washburn, meanwhile, patrolling that baseline, seems to get a field goal anytime the Wolfpack want it.
The poise that Coach B was talking about.
For a very young team, they sort of, oh, there's a mistake. Shackelford misjudging McMillan's or Myers' move. And so Carolina, trailing by 7, takes it down court. 3 minutes, 10 seconds left.
Myers was clearing out. Big shot right here. Big. I'd have Lebo take it if he could.
Knocked away, Wolf, goaltending on Shackelford, and it's 62-57. 10 points for Wolf.
A lot of pressure up court, for the one-man zone, back to Wolf.
Rantino Smith, he has the fouls to give, his second, and now it's 16 fouls on Carolina. State has committed only 3 in the second half.
All right, now they're going to foul. They got to pick the weaker foul shooters.
Myers is not the man to foul. He leads the Atlantic Coast Conference, at least in league play, in free throw shooting. That's Myers with the ball. Ooh, takes a tough shot. 7-point lead again with 2:25 left. Foul on McMillan.
That's only the third foul on State. A very difficult shot from the corner this time by E, especially in this time of the game. But he's been around a long time. He's a positive thinker.
I'll tell you what, though, those are the kinds of shots that make you want to be an athletic director.
Oh, I don't think. I think Coach B would be an athletic director about 2 meetings.
Team is in it.
Well, they got 2 timeouts left, and they fouled the wrong guy. Bolton's unbelievable outside shooter. Pretty hard when you take 2 players out of the starting lineup here. You take one out and cover, but Martin's an important person on that baseline, and Hale is the leader.
Bolton. What do they say? NBC, nothing but cotton. Bolton has done that all day. 15 points and his 7 field goals, almost every one from fairly long range. Yeah. 66-57 with time running out on North Carolina. Ranzino Smith, it counts, and he was fouled. Nate McMillan says, I fouled him before the shot.
It was a good foul if you could get him before the shot, because they've only committed four personal fouls, or three.
I think that's what he was trying to do, yep. The thinking senior. He wasn't figuring Ranzino Smith was going to shoot.
So you're looking at a possible four-point play here. They're in a 2-3 zone. The shot comes from the outside.
Rebound by Bolton.
They needed that shot by Smith that time, Dick. Now they're really spread out.
Levo with a foul. That'll send McMillan to the line. He, too, a good shooter, 76% on the year. Popson called upon. For the intensity of the competition in this conference. And of course, everyone is pointing at North Carolina.
Well, very tough to play in Reynolds here. This is a difficult place to come out with a win. Also, Cameron.
The reason why at the other end Carolina got the basket but did not shoot the free throw, the foul was after the shot, away from the ball, so they got the shot and the ball, too. McMillan. Well, he has had an outstanding game. What a save by Ranzino Smith. Kenny Smith fouled by Myers. That will be the sixth team foul on State.
Watch Zeno really hustle for this save.
Oh, he was about 15 feet into the backcourt midair. Terrific camera work. Our NBC crew to capture the subtleties and the power of this action in Raleigh. Lebo, good fake, off-balance throw, and Doherty nudges it home. Timeout, Carolina, with 1 minute and 25 seconds left at Reynolds Coliseum at State 68, Carolina 61. Here's the reaction as North Carolina scored at the other end.
What he's saying, the tap's no good. Then he said, hey, give me a walk. Give me something. I'll take a walk.
In a way, he does remind me of a guy that used to coach up at Marquette.
Well, he reminds me more of a movie actor, Al P.
Al P. who? Al P. You don't know his last name, do you?
Pacino.
Hey, see there, you knew it all the time. Steve Pucknell in for North Carolina. 68-61 State. 1 minute, 25 seconds left. And as Al McGuire said, it would not be an upset. Foul is on Steve Bucknell. In case you just wandered in from Sunday with a family and joining us, North Carolina State has led throughout. Carolina never had the lead. Carolina playing without two key performers. Starter Steve Hale out with a punctured lung, but will return in a week. And Warren Martin, their seven-footer, a bad foot. There they are. 16 points today for Benny Bolton. He's had a big game. Has he missed anything?
Well, he's a zone buster, and I was surprised that they left him alone on the outside. He must have bottom five of them out there.
This would be for his career high. 18. So he saved his best for Carolina today. Lebo inside to Wolf. Out of bounds. see if you agree with this statement. North Carolina State won it today with their defense.
Early in the game, their defense, their baseline, psyched out the baseline of North Carolina, especially Wolf, and I thought they affected Doherty's play today. The national rankings right now, Dick, will go to Duke. They are truly number one.
How far does Carolina drop losing two this week?
Oh, Carolina drops way down to two. Even with the second loss. They did something this week that was rare. I don't know why they took that week off. They had about 8 days off. Coach Dean allowed his ball players 3 or 4 days off, which you never really allowed during the season. But he's retooling, I guess, for the conference tournament and then the run to the Roses to Dallas and gunfight OK Corral in late March.
Nate McMillan has just scored his 9th point. That does not tell the story of the performance of this athlete.
If he's not struggling, North Carolina State is a dynamite team. If he's struggling, then they're questionable.
Ranzino to Kenny, forces the little jumper. Rebound, Bolton. Final minute, and they're celebrating in Raleigh.
Prepared for the situation where maybe he can steal one, which he did against Marquette University earlier in the year.
Meanwhile, with only 40 seconds left, assistant coach Bill Guthridge next to Dean Smith. He's got his cleats on now. He's getting ready to go.
He's going to be on the block soon.
Hands on the key.
All right. We got 40 seconds. Lost his concentration that time.
Ranzino to Doherty. A gimme. Albano fighting to the very end despite a 9-point lead and only 32 seconds left.
I'm going to buy his cookbook. Albano, I think I should buy his cookbook.
Especially after he gives all of 5% of the receipts to his mother who wrote it for him. Here are the Atlantic Coast Conference standings starting today. Duke will enjoy a one-game lead over Carolina. They meet again next Sunday, and we'll have that one for you on NBC. Georgia Tech, only a game back. They won last night. Virginia, and of course, we're assuming North Carolina State a winner today.
Dick, earlier in the year, I do a little book in the summertime, and in August, I picked Georgia Tech to win it all.
Have you changed your mind?
Not really. I thought that Sally started to play real soft. Doherty pulled him down. That's an intentional foul. Two-shot foul. He pulled him down, then apologized. He pulled Shackelford down. If we can catch a replay on that, it'd be interesting.
Shackelford, a 62% shooter. Obviously, in the timeout, they said, you fouled that man.
You're better off giving him two shots than someone else one and one, say a Bolton. But the game's over anyway, and Dean is just rehearsing for the postseason conference tournament and the NCAA.
They have those statistics on the bench, and noting that Shackelford had the poorest shooting percentage of the men in the game for State. That's the man they fouled. They gave him two. State have the lock. Guthridge has the key. Thirty seconds left, 31, 74, 63, North Carolina State.
Dean constantly working, puts a sub in, stops the clock, gets his team organized, 31 seconds. And Coach Bill Guthridge does have that key in his pocket.
Lebo, Jeff Lebo. Timeout again for North Carolina.
That's why Coach Smith is such an excellent teacher. He uses every opportunity to teach.
Is it disturbing, though, to a team that has really been so dominant all year long? Number one, number one, number one. And suddenly you lose two in a row. Now, some say a good team can take advantage of a defeat late in the season. That was historically so with UCLA under John Wooden. But two losses, and it doesn't get much easier. Virginia at home and then at Duke next week for Carolina.
Well, what I think, Dick, I think that break in the middle of the year, not the middle of the year, the end of the year, where they took 8 days off last week. The reason for the break is they say that they had a change for the other network, the other network that shows basketball with meatball head Billy Packer. That Marquette game was supposed to be last Sunday, and they changed that date. So that gave North Carolina 7-8 days off. Dean gave his team 4 days off, and that ended up, I think, breaking their rhythm. But they have plenty of time to get back in rhythm and, again, make the run. They are a Final Four team. There's no doubt about it. And, again, two guys down today. They did a good job, but State just did excellent. Coach B had his team prepared. And this is one of the toughest courts, I believe, in the country to come in and play to. And I even think that Coach Bill Guthridge got the wrong key from Coach B.
Well, it's not only the noise here at the Reynolds Coliseum, but they play on a non-wood surface, the tartan surface, and you don't have the opportunity to play on that surface very often, and the visitors have to make an adjustment. The sounds of the ball and the way it reacts off this court is a bit different than on wood. Don't forget, super teams to follow on Sports World, and you'll see your favorite athletes from around the National Football League in action in Hawaii. Nate McMillan at the line for North Carolina State. Rebound to Ranzino Smith. Zone rebound. Rebound Shackelford. Joe Wolt comes out holding his knee again. The coup de grace. Slingshot Schneiderman, Dr. Dennis Hemberg for our statistics. The executive producer of NBC Sports is Michael Weissman. Coordinating producer of NBC Basketball, George Finkel. Today's game produced by David Neal, directed by Andy Rosenberg. Stay tuned for Sports.